Okay, can you say and spell your first and last name and then your title?
Jason Oliphant, J-A-S-O-N-O-L-I-P-H-A-N-T, Fire Chief of Montgomery County ESD-1.
So we're looking at what used to be a home. Can you explain to us what happened and what time?
We were dispatched to a residential fire at approximately 5 o'clock this morning. When units arrived, they came to a debris field here, which we found it was a house that exploded. We had three adult patients. They were transported by a lifeline helicopter to Memorial Hermann. At this time, the fire marshal's office is on location. They will be getting assistance from the Railroad Commission and ATF.
There was a husband and wife inside and a third adult. Can you talk to me about the victims?
Right now, this is three. It's under investigation. There's three adult patients. They were transported.
Male or female?
Two male and female.
And you don't know what condition they were in, critical or stable?
We were told they were in critical condition.
All three?
Yeah, all three in critical condition.
Doesn't look like you had a lot of fire. As far as when you arrived on the scene, was there any fire at all?
They had two small fires when they arrived on location.
Just unusual, though. I mean, I see debris all the way.
Yeah, we have a debris. We have a debris field approximately 600 feet from where the residence was.
It's like snow in the trees up there, almost.
Yes, it does.
Is that gonna make it difficult to figure out the cause?
Like I said, they're investigating right now. They'll have assistance from ATF and Railroad Commission out later on today. They're en route to the scene at this time.
But you suppose this road will be blocked off throughout the day?
I believe so. Should be blocked off for a while. This is just a residential street, so. All right.
Thank you.
Yes.
What's your name?
My name is Carl Taylor.
I'm sorry?
Carl Taylor.
First name again?
Carl.
Carl?
Taylor.
Taylor, okay.
Yes, sir.
Carl, tell me how did you hear this morning? Just woke you up?
Well, I was in dead sleep and it woke me up. It sounded like a transformer blowing up the back of the house. I got the head down, drove to the front of the neighborhood, and that's when the police started showing up in helicopters, and the house was leveled. I mean, the order was pretty bad explosion. It was loud, real loud.
And you're back quite a ways down on the subdivision?
I'm probably about a mile back, yes, sir.
What, any, did you see any of the victims or anything? Or were they still
working? See none of the victims. My wife and my neighbor come down and saw them and said they was in pretty bad shape. They was already out on the road. One lady was in pretty bad shape. They couldn't see the other, and they had to leave because they started marking off the place to do their investigation.
First of all, what's your name?
Emily.
Emily, what's your last name?
Love.
Emily, tell me what you heard this morning.
A huge explosion. It sounded like a bomb or gas plant had exploded, but there's no gas plant out here.
When did you realize what it was?
About 5:30 when we drove down here to check on some neighbors.
What did it look like at that point?
Complete chaos. Complete chaos. Trucks, lights, police, fire department, everywhere.
What about, you said it set the alarms off at your house too?
Yes, it set the truck alarm off.
What about the injuries? Did you see, were they still in the helicopters when you got here or not?
The helicopters were landing.
Were landing, man?
Yeah.
Okay. All right.